7, aka Oh Hell No, presents The Senate. Hello everyone, Dr. Novocaine is in the house, and the prescription for today is The Senate, a Super Mario World ROM hack by F7, requested by Daryl Data. Hopefully he's still watching in the months between the actual recording of this and the uploading of it. Between cutscenes, press up. I am going in completely blind! As per usual. Note. This hack is fiction and is not a spoof of any real Senate. Have fun. Why do we need a disclaimer like that? Very special thanks to the Mr. Wester and the SMW Central community. Huh? What? Princess Peach, come quick! He's awake! He's finally awake! Later. We're doing a time skip already, huh? Alright then. Mario, I was so worried you'd never wake up again. After your 3-month absence, I don't know anyone who could help us. Mario, use your words. Oh, I'm sorry. I should have told you what happened. Do you remember the toad who brought you that special anonymous gift? No, I do not. Well, the wine inside it was apparently poisoned, and after you drank it, you collapsed. Kids, let this be a lesson. Don't drink strange wine. Within weeks after that, we received letters from desperate toads saying their lands had been captured by some extremely powerful enemies. Shock and amazement! They call themselves the Senate, and all we know is that their leader is called Agamemnon. I was forced to move to hide to my hideout to prevent myself getting captured. Agamemnon, name is familiar, but I can't place it. I'm sure I will find out before I go too far in. Even Bowser and his son have fled, if my source is trustworthy. Well, that's no good. Shock and amazement, times 3! You understand that I ask you, who saved me 100,000 times, I'm sorry for that, to save us. Well, what else am I gonna do? It's Tuesday. Oh, and good luck, Mario, you'll definitely need it. Definitely need it. Well, that's promising. When Mario arrives on the beach, he immediately knows that there's something wrong. The beaches aren't enjoyed by toads anymore, but by enemies! And I'm just going to clobber them because they're probably just out on a beach vacation, but they're still my enemies, so... Alright. So, let's head to Pineapple Beach 1. And there's a treasure chest, I want that. The treasure chest is just background. Sadness. Trees, however, are not. They lead us to the giant coins. So, we're starting off pretty basic central here. They are power bracelet coins, apparently. I'm gonna call them P-coins. Okay, so far this is just basic vanilla type stuff. And hey, fire! Been a while. Other than that, not too much to say. Bunch of Goombas, bunch of Koopas, bunch of fishies. Bunch of me going to pipes. Have you collected one of the moon coins? If you find 5 in one single level, you get an extra life. Moon coins! Really? Whatever you say, I'm calling them power bracelet coins. That's what they look like to me, and that's what I'm sticking. This hack is meant to be played without save states, don't worry, it will not get ridiculously hard. Good luck. Well, it's meant to be played without save states. Let's see if that holds up. As it is, I will be making a concerted effort to stick to save states just in between levels, so fail safes. But if the game gets to be frustrating, I always reserve the right to use them as anti-frustration features. So, Pineapple Beach 2. We aren't really on a beach anymore. This is false advertising. No wonder Agamemnon was taking this place over. Clearly he's been getting angry at the false advertising. If you see the red level tile on the map, the level contains a secret exit, find and unlock additional levels and cool bonuses. Yes, we know! It always bugs me, just the tiniest bit, that, they assume that people assume that we're playing this game without knowing the slightest thing about Super Mario World. These games are not played by people who are ignorant of the fact. So there's a secret exit somewhere, so I should really be checking some of these pipes. That's a big negative! So far, though, nothing special for getting the Dragon Coins, except the extra life. When is the next game I play that's going to have something special for that? Might be SMW, yeah. Definitely thinking about it! Anyway, crud. You know what? I'm betting that that was the pipe that we needed to go through. Because it had a bunch of coins over it, and there's no going back. Oh well. Guess I'll be coming back then. I had to come back anyway, so... And yet, I'm still gonna try checking some of these pipes, because you never know. And also, they could lead to goodies anyway. Like that first one. Okay, a vine. Let me guess. This is the last power present coin. And I don't think I want to jump from up there because the threat of danger looms. And a goal orb instead of a goal post. Well, whatever. I guess they're not going to give me bonus games as often in this game. But we have stuff to do, so let's head back quick and do it. Congratulations, you have found a secret exit, or at least the room where it's hidden. Simply bring the key to the keyhole to achieve it. Whoa. So much for pressing the jump button. Alright, in we go. That appears to be a shortcut, so we'll quickly open it up, and then, meet around at the other end. Pineapple Beach A. Oh, this is music I've heard in hacks before. I don't remember which one, though. Huh. Let's get going then. to, and by get going, I mean my, actual yammering, because I haven't been saying anything. Alright. This is, kind of your very basic grassland level again. Well, I guess it can't be expected to be too difficult. Well, it feels like there should be things hidden some... Whoa! I thought auto-scroll had started for a moment. Apparently not. This is a very rompy game so far. Just kind of basically run through and get some bonus stars at the goal gate. And yep, that's just a shortcut. So, let's finish things off at Pineapple Beach 3. Which, once again, is not a beach. Actually, the only thing that's been a beach so far is the first stage. You can just call it, like, Pineapple Land or something like that. Solidity. I swear, if this box is gonna tell me about P-switches... All doors who have different colors than normal ones are reset doors. They use them when they are stuck to return the same section. Okay, that is actually helpful. So, the blue doors count as reset doors, and so will green doors, white doors, orange doors, chartreuse doors, viridian doors, violet, indigo, pretty much anything except yellow doors. Whoa. Thank you! The convenient line of coins that stopped me from running myself off the edge because I wasn't paying attention. Midpoint! Up, no, down! Into the depths we go. If you don't want to get eaten by some pesky munchers, you better follow those coins, Mario. Really? And I missed the coin, but whatever. Guess I'm not getting all of them in this one. Whoop-de-doo. Guess I still have my fire. Onward we go. I guess this level has beach at the end, so it's not as much of a lie. And killing enemies even after I'm defeated. That's the Mario way. Wait, I just said that so wrong it's breaking my brain, so we'll end that here. Anyway, that's all for me for now. Until next time, this is Doc. I'll see you later.